When digital photography first started, it was all about who could build the camera with the highest resolution, the highest megapixel count. When models were doubling megapixels from 2 to 4, from 6 to 12, there was a noticeable difference in image quality. Today, we still have 10 to 12 megapixel cameras on the market, but there are also offerings in excess of 50 plus megapixels, so that begs the question, how important are megapixels really? Now, there are definitely advantages in working with higher resolution camera systems, and this couldn't be more true than when talking about printing work. Generally speaking, professional quality images are printed at about 300 dpi, meaning each square inch is approximately 300 by 300 pixels in size. So if you have a 24 megapixel camera with a 6,000 by 4,000 pixel resolution, you can safely print up to 20 by 13.3 inches with excellent sharpness. Now, when you get into the 50 megapixel resolution game, you can bring that print size up to 29 by 19.3 inches with ease. Now, this doesn't mean that you can't make great photographic prints with a lower resolution camera. Using modern imaging software, smart upscaling, and an understanding of viewing distances, you can produce outstanding prints. And billboards are a great example of this. They're printed at extremely low DPIs because you aren't going to be looking at them up close like you would a print in a gallery. So 100 or even 50 DPI looks great. But when you're printing highly detailed images that folks are going to see up close, megapixels definitely matter. Higher megapixel count also offers greater flexibility in post-production, in things like cropping, retouching, and compositing. So yes, megapixel counts are important to many fine art, landscape, and commercial product photographers. Layout and graphic designers also appreciate the flexibility offered from the extra information and detail. But whether you shoot professional sports or just make snaps of your daily life, it's hard to find an application that won't benefit in some way from more megapixels. However, there are some downsides to working with ultra-high resolutions. More megapixels means more heavy lifting during image acquisition, and that means slower continuous shooting, slower autofocus performance, and a generally less responsive shooting experience. Other considerations are more resource-intensive post-production and the need for higher capacity memory cards and disk storage solutions. But the biggest downside to more megapixels is high ISO performance. That's not to say there aren't newer cameras that push the limits of ultra-high resolution capture without sacrificing much of their raw speed or low-light performance. Many manufacturers also produce more conservative, lower resolution models. And these options generally boast faster processing speed, boosted frames per second rates, sensor readout, and vastly improved high ISO and low light performance. Another place where we see a huge advantage with lower resolution sensors is video. And this is because fewer pixels to read out for the camera generally means faster imaging processing, and that reduces things like rolling shutter from impacting your video quality. Also, the ability to process the data easier results in proper downsampling for video with fewer artifacts and aliasing. Also, you get the same advantages in low light as you do with still photography. So I guess the answer to the question, how important are megapixels, isn't really as clear cut as we'd hoped. But the number of pixels on a camera is no longer a good gauge with which to compare systems. If you do a lot of printing, shoot in a studio, or want landscapes with exceptional detail, a high-resolution camera is an obvious choice. For those looking for better low-light performance or improved video, more conservative options are likely the better performers. For more on megapixels, photography, and all things imaging, visit B&H. I'm photographer David Flores. See you next time.